Ok, đăng nhập vào Khan Academy. Đơn giản nhất là chọn vào Google. Vui lòng chờ trong giây lát. Rồi, hôm nay chúng ta sẽ cùng nhau học toán lớp 2. Ok, toán lớp 2. Bắt đầu thử thách lớp học xem nào. Thế chúng ta đã biết được bao nhiêu phần trăm what do you think sport fin length socks 75 meter football 94 baseball 121 meters. How much longer is a football field than a soccer field? Okay. Four cannot deduct five. You need 14 deduct five, isn't it? Nine. And then nine deduct one become 8 90. Check. Correct. Excellent. Next question. Oh, Ian, 7 elephant ride. Part 3. Shape 5. Create a picture graph to show how many elephant ride each friend had. 1 is 1 elephant ride. Okay. Now we can do that. We can put should have something. Let's see. No. Not easy. Ah, here. Shy. 5. Correct. And part. Let's click. And that's the elephant. Okay, it should work. 3. Ah, I know. Click in. And click elephant. Try it down. Okay, 5. No, it's 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I have 2. 1 here. Let go. 1. 1 more. Delete that. Delete that. Correct. Hey, part 3. Shape 5 in 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You need to speak. You need to count it. Okay. Check. Right. 28 more. Let's go. Wow. Easy. 6 plus 7, 13. Oh, 12, 13. Easy to make mistake. Next question. Quick is closest to how long a coach is. Inch and feet. Huh, I don't know. I select one. Coach. Cannot be, can be feet. Let's select feet. Feet is your feet. Inch is something not easy. Correct. So it should have click here. Here. 93. Bigger that 66. Oh, correct. Next. Which is worth the most? Which is worth the most? 10 $5 bean. 7 $10 bean. 3 $20 bean. 10 $5. That means 50. 7 $10. That means 70. 320, that means 60. This 70.
They are offline, look
like. What? Okay, good. X. Match a number to it written for. 749. 794. 179. Okay, how to move? Moving it. 94 79 49. Correct. Check. Great work. Hey, easy. Which pencil measures 4 centimeters? 1 centimeters, 1, 2, 3, 4. D. Pencil D. Pencil D. Okay. Next question. Which shape has 5 angles? 3 angles. 5 angles. Easy. Let's check. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Next. Which choices describe the number of square? So if your children want to learn, các con mà muốn học thì phải đọc mới được. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. It's 6. It's 8. It's 8. Choose 2 answers. Okay. This one. This one. Okay, it's enough for me now. Go. Okay, let's go to one lesson. Same. Let's see. So, for money and time. Let's see. Interesting. Money and time. Bài học này chúng ta sẽ học về cách sử dụng tiền và thời gian. Bắt đầu với việc xác định giá trị của tiền xu và tiền giấy đô la Mỹ. Let's start. Bạn sẵn sàng để thực tập chưa? 7 câu hỏi. Ok, show us what you can do. Let's go. What is it? A bin is one below. What is the value of the bin? $1 or up is more. I cannot see it. So is it 5? I see number 5 here, so it's $5. Okay. Next question. Coin. This coin, quarter dollar, that means 25 cents. Quarter là 1/4. Quarter của 100 cent là 25 cents. Correct. Continue. Which bin is worth 25? 1, 20, 10. This 10. 20 and this 10. And this 1 and this 5. You need to remember this. Next one. Vậy là lớp 2 các em đã học về tiền bạc. Which coin is... we which quarter dollar this one, and what is one dollar? Is one dim?
Yes, of them. Although I get fed up with the something stuff on my board. I need the one that like music, which is lava link.
$1.
Struggling to find some. For my hero pool, like because my bot hosts on hero pool, and
what the coin? Cannot see 1 cent, yeah. 5 cent, 25.
And lava dot link, and basically has
too small.
Has tons
of too small. Too small. $0.05, at least I can read it.
Technically, my code
been worth $1, $20, $10, yeah, $5.
Yeah, I mean, not that, I mean the lava link host.
Right.
What's up?
You live
it up. My old server done. And host it on Heroku instead.
No.
Although technically their support
server in count money, like counting dollar, counting American coin. Yeah, we have the video.
Let's get some practice counting money. So I have 6 coins right over here. And these are all United States coins, or counting money in the United States for these examples. And what is this first coin? Well, this is called a quarter, or a quarter dollar. So it represents 25 cents. And we could write it out as 25 cents. But I'll just write it as 20. Well, I'll just keep that one like that. Now, this one's another quarter. So it is also going to be, 25 cents. Now, this one looks different, but it's just the other side of this coin, of these coins. This is what the other side looks like. So this is also going to be 25 cents. These are 3/4 right over here. So how much money do these 3/4 represent? Well, it's going to be 25 plus 25, which is 50, plus 25, which is going to be 75. So these 3/4 are going to be 75 cents. And remember, 100 cents make a dollar. So this is still less than $1. But we're not done yet. We have this nickel. This is a nickel right over here. That represents 5 cents. And then we have another nickel here. It looks different, but it's just the other side. This is the head side. This is the tail side. So this is also another 5 cents. And so these two nickels, if you add them together, they are going to represent 10 cents. And then finally, you have a penny. And a penny, and it even says it right over here, is 1 cent. In fact, they all say it here. This is 5 cents. This is 1 cent. So this right over here is going to be 1 cent. So what is 75 plus 10 plus 1? Well, 75 plus 10 is 85, plus 1 is 86. So this is equal to 86 cents. And if it felt a little bit too fast to count up 25, 50, 75 in your head, you could also add them up. 25, 25, 25, plus 5, plus 5, and another 5, plus 1, plus 1. You could add them up this way, and then what would you get? 5 plus 5 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 5 is 20, plus 5 is 25, plus 1 is 26. So that's 2 tens and 1 6. Put the 2 tens up here. 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8. So you could get 86 cents either way. Let's do one that has even more coins in it. So here we go. We have, so what is it? What's going on here? This right over here is a quarter. That's going to be 25 cents. 25 cents. And then we have one that we didn't see in the previous example. We have 2 dimes. A dime represents 10 cents. So we have 2 dimes, or we could have those each represent 10 cents. Then we have 2 nickels. We've already seen those each represent 5 cents. So 5 and 5. And then we have 4 pennies. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we could put each penny separately like that. Or we could say, look, 4 pennies, each of them represent 1 cent. So that's going to be 4 cents. So let me do it that way. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, that's going to be 4 cents. And then we could just add everything up. So 5 plus 0 plus 0 plus 5 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 4 is 19. 19 is 1 10 and 9 1, so I can put the 1 10 in the tens place. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 1 is 4, plus 1 is 5. So it's 5 tens, 5 tens and 9 ones. So 59 cents. This right over here is 59 cents. And notice, we have more coins, but it represents less value than the previous example. That's because we had a lot of coins that didn't represent a lot of values. Like we had these 4 pennies here. Well, in the previous example, we had 3 quarters. Quarters represent, each of these quarters is equivalent to 25 pennies. So we're able to represent more money with fewer coins in the first example. Zhang Tao has 2 $1 bills. So 2 $1 bills. So let's just write that as 1 plus 1, because each $1 bill represents $1. So $1 plus $1. That's the 2 $1 bills. $1 $5 bill. $1 $5 bill. So that represents $5. And $3 $10 bills. $3 $10 bills. So that's plus 10, plus 10, plus 10. How much money does he have in all? Well, let's see, let's see if we calculate it. 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 5 is 7. So these are going to be $7. And then 10 plus 10 plus 10, that's 3 tens. So that's going to be $30. Now what's 7 ones plus 3 tens, or what's 7 plus 30? Well, that's going to be $37. So Zhang Tao has $37 in all. Let's do another one of these. Dia has 6 $1 bills. And actually, let's draw it out. Dia has 6 $1 bills. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And these are $1 bills. So $1 bills. This is my rough drawing of $1 bills. To draw a lot of $1 bills here. So she has 6 $1 bills. She has 3 $5 bills. Let me do that in a different color. So 3 $5 bills. So 1, so that's a $5 bill. 2, that's a $5 bill. And 3 $5 bills. That little circle, in, that's supposed to be the picture of someone. Let me make it clear that these are pictures of folks, of famous historical figures. So these are pictures of famous historical figures here. And then finally, she has $1 $10 bill. $1 $10 bill. So $1 $10 bill. So it's worth $10. Picture of famous historical figure right over there. So how much money does she have in all? Well, the 6 $1 bills, that's going to be $6. The 3 $5 bills, that's going to be worth $5, $10, $15. So plus $15. And then the $1 $10 bill, that's going to be worth $10. $10. So what's 6 plus 15 plus 10? Well, let's see, 6 plus 15 is going to be 21. 21 plus 10 is going to be equal to $31. Is equal to $31. And you could have also added it this way. You could have said 15. plus 10, plus 10, plus 6, plus 6, add them together, and we would have gotten 5 plus 0 plus 6 is 11. That's 1, 1, and 1, 10. And then you have 3 tens here. So $31.
Whistle. $1, 10 cents, 1 cent, and this one, 5 cents. Nickel. Harry has smart money in a piggy bank. Piggy bank. Piggy bank. In a piggy bank. You have a piggy bank. She got $2 $1 bills. $1 $10 bill. How much? Oh, 10, 20, yeah. 25, 26. And she got $2, $2, $2, $12, $26, and $12.
Yeah, I did try that stuff.
Total value of those coins, 25, 25.
All right.
$75, 5, 5, 10.
Oh,
85. 83. Okay. What? Not quarter dollar. 25.
Oops.
Yeah, 75, 75, 50, 75, 80, 85, and 90, 93. Good job. All right, next question. $10. Easy. Okay, next question. Has 22 cents. Weak set of coin could have 20, 32 cents. 32 cents. Nope, too much. Already 52. My this one, 2 cents. Ah, 10, 10, 10.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe this one. 10, 10, 30. Chuck. Bah, incorrect. Okay. 25.
What?
30. Ah, this one. 25, 5, 30. Okay, check. Alright. 11 up. Okay, done.
Financial aid, the only thing to remember is to actually go to that course and click on the financial aid button. But since it's archived,
so you can try again. Try again. Next up. Let's go. $93. Next question. Now we know. This one, quarter, 30, 32. Next question. Okay, 80. 80 should be 40, 20, 20, 20, 20, 40, 60, 80. Jump. Next question. Okay, 20, 40, 60, 80, 90. Okay. Let's check. Next question. Ah, 9 nickel and 2 penny. Okay. Nickel, I don't know. Wait, damit, nickel, quarter 25, dim is 10, nickel is 5. So 3 quarters, that means 75.
Yeah,
85, 1982 is correct. Next one, 71, 1 being correct. 4, no. Oop, sorry. $7, $10 mean and $15. Sorry, my mistake. This one, 3, 10, 60, 1, 10, 70, 71. Yeah. Next one. That mean quarter. Now we have 75, 1 dim, 5, 30, 35, 60, 85, 89. It should be, oop, try again. Opa. Damn. Huang, how much is dam? Dam is 5 or 10? Dam is 5 or 10?
The 10.
Okay. So 75, 95, and 99. Damn it, 10. Oop. Not correct, 99. 1, 2, 3, 4. What the? And this one, what the? No, it should be quarter, let's see. Okay, I quit. Count money word problem, let's try.
What?
$3, $20 beans, that means 60, $7, $10 means 70, $10, $5 beans, that means 50, so $70. Check. Expression. Let me know 25, 26, 26, and then 2, 6 and 12. That mean 38. Okay. Next question is 45 cents. 1/4 dam. Okay, dam is 10. That means chuck. So, Oga has 1 dam, that means 10 cents. 2 nickel, that means 10 cents. 20, 23. Her Oma gave the following coin from her purse. Quarter and half dollar. So we need to use a pension account.
Tomorrow, according to the time zone.
You have never 23 plus this one. Seven. Let's try. In God. Oh my God. You can try 92. Chocolate. Correct. Done. Sixty% now, Lee. So you can have time on number 9. So that is good for. But let's keep it for tomorrow. It's a talk today. See you tomorrow. Bye.